Yes, I'm one of them. Yes. Yes. Oh, yes. Ooh, beefcake.
Yeah, how come he's the only one with his shirt off?
That's... You know, he can have it. I was married now. It does nothing for me.
So first of all, I've been doing press rooms all day. You have the best outfit.
Oh, brother, I appreciate that. Thank you. Thank you. Yes, very Scottish. Yes.
So how is your Nick relationship going to change now that, at least as the season starts, he doesn't have his Grimm powers anymore?
He'll need me more. You know what I mean? I think we're on common ground, you know, this guy's right now. And I think he'll have to sort of go back to being a detective, you know what I mean? And sort of seeing how that works. And, you know, and it's interesting because, like, we shot one of the scenes in the first episode, and we go to the trailer, and we get in trouble there. And it's like, what are you doing here? And it's like, oh, yeah, that's right. You're the Grimm. We need your help now, you know? And, like, so we're both, like, I used to be the outside, like, looking and going. And now we're both, like, sort of sitting there, like, watching the Grimm. We're going, what do you see? Like, you know, what do you know? What do you think? And, no, it's fun. We're on common ground, and, you know, my joke is sort of being, like, now I'm more exposed, so I'm going to have to carry a bigger gun and wear a black jacket now. And, like, you know, my crew won't bounce bullets off, you know what I mean? Yeah, so, we'll see. You know, we'll see what they have in store. You know, obviously, I'm mad. I don't know what the fuck is going on.
But are you curious? You asked about the writers.
Well, you know, I am curious, but I also like it. I like every script is like handled like a breadcrumb, you know what I mean? And I like the idea of sort of learning, you know, as we go. Yeah, I mean, you know, as the actor, you know, you get a new script and you read and you go, oh, wow, I didn't expect that. And you may call them and ask them one or two different things or whatever, but I think it's also much more interesting for me as an actor. To be surprised, right? Because then you're asking yourself, okay, I have a little bit of time to figure out how I'm going to play this and what's going to happen versus knowing every, you know, thing too far ahead of time, you know.
At this point, you know your character.
At this point, I know my character. I can hop into it, and but it's always better to be surprised. Yeah. Yeah. I was nervous as a hoe in church the first time I came here. Didn't know what to expect.
Was your first time at Comic-Con?
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. Didn't know what to expect. Didn't know, you know, just, it was just kind of chaos and mayhem, you know, was here. And, you know, honestly, it was weird for me. And so you just had to learn to tread lightly. And the other thing is we didn't know anything about the show. You know, so everybody's asking you all these questions, and I didn't even know enough to even make up shit. You know what I mean? you know, you just had the pilot, yeah. And so we're all, like, really just trying to do some interesting guesses and things about it. But it's, you know, it's got a lot more easy to navigate, and it's gotten warmer as far as dealing with the press and the audience, and that we're an accepted sort of known entity, and we have some success. You know, it's a, not as big as Game of Thrones and all these other shows, you know what I mean? But I'll take it. You know, I still have anonymity, you know, which I appreciate. Right. Yeah.
Are there any legends that the show hasn't tackled yet that you would love to see them tackle?
Well, not a legend. You know, one of my favorite fairy tales is Rumpelstiltskin. And, you know, growing up in Oakland, I look at, like, Rumpelstiltskin as, like, this, like, cool pimp who drives a Cadillac. You know what I mean? And it's like, you know, it's like, yeah, I'll turn this into some, you know, you need to help me make some money. I'm going to help you make some money, but you got to learn my name. I don't know. There's just the obscure ones left. You know,
that seems like a lot of them.
I haven't read. You know. So, you know, the first 10 or 20 that everybody knows, you know, I've read over and over again. Now it's just kind of like, we'll see what happens. But also they're mixing a lot of them, too. So, you know, they're from other countries and, you know, different cultures and whatnot like that. So that's interesting. But at the same time, my memory is like a sieve. So, you know, you just learn and it just kind of goes. You know. But yeah, so it's cool.
Thank you.
I don't get scared. No, I only thing I'm scared of are rats. So when we had the rat episode, I was scared. I'm terrified of rats. I tell my wife, if we have a mouse or rat in the house ever, or we see, I cannot save her. You know, and so she still decided to marry me.
Saving from a rat.
But you never know, they get big.
You know what I mean? So you'll be letting out the girly scream while she gets the broom?
It's happening. It's happening. It was like divorceable grounds, like grounds for divorce. She's like, are you serious? Like, high pitch? That's you?
All right. Take care. Have a